Sanctuary.
Listen, has anybody ever felt like
here at Baseball Memorial, we are so blessed to have such a great worship experience, which is led by our dynamic music department. In that music department, we have various groups as our Anointed Voices, our Judah Praise Team, our Men of Bass, where all the men of bass get together and they sing on one accord, and it's such a powerful sight to see. Our Pure Worship, we also have United Voices of Praise, our Vessels of Praise, and then we have our Young Adults Choir. Now, each one of these choirs and praise teams has such a unique sound, but when they all get together and praise God at once, and our mass choir sings, it's one of the greatest worship experiences.
My worship experience this past year at Bates Memorial has really grown and expanded beyond my expectations due to the drama ministry. This past year, the drama ministry has put on amazing productions, such as the Black History production, the Resurrection Sunday, and most recently, the Gospel Nativity production. These productions have been a wonderful experience to partake in and has really helped enrich my worship experience here at Bates Memorial.
We're elevated during our annual weekend, such as our Bates Bible Institute, which is put in place to help us become better Christians and to grow as disciples in Christ. Our church anniversary, which shows us the legacy of where we came from and the wonder of where we're going. Then we have our children's, youth, and young adult weekend, which is a weekend and even a month jam-packed full of activities for our youth and young adults to have an alternative from what's out there in the streets. And then we have our men's weekend, where our men's get together and they, you know, come on one accord in unity and praise God and worship God during our conference as well. And then the women get together in unity and in spirit, and they really come together in one accord during their conference and their weekend. And then we have our seniors' weekend, which is so powerful to me because it pays homage to those who paved the way for us so that we can be where we are today.
We want you to know tonight that you don't have to leave here the same way you came.
Seeing these souls come forward to be saved fills my heart with joy, because I can remember when I came down those aisles to be saved.
If you live without Christ, you are living way below your privilege. For God has provided through Christ the greatest gift you could ever have, and that is the gift of everlasting life.
As a member of Bates, one of the things that I am most thrilled about is the mandate of going and making disciples. This has helped me in my own life simply because I understand that it's important to have a relationship with God. And so when I go out, or when someone leaves Bates and goes out into the community, they're not just saying a few cliches, they're not just repeating what they've heard, but they know the Word of God.
We offer a whole host of opportunities to help us continue to learn what it is that Christ wants from us, be it through our church school classes offered various times during the week, our Master Life classes, new member classes, special studies opportunities. All of those times are opportunities for us to continue to learn what it is that Christ demands of us.
The Ride or Die Youth Ministries really works with our kids to try to mature them into discipleship, mature them into a life, a godly life, a Christ-centered life. We have a lot of ways that we do that. We have mentoring programs like Spice and Pack.
We're maturing our youth, especially our young men.
We have Bible studies, high school and middle school divisions. And we also prepare them for life and maturity through college tours. It is so important for us to instill a sense of Christ in them and let them grow into it. As they mature in age, they will mature in Christ.
Changing the world. God has commanded us to love one another. We're changing.
We've been compassionately ministering to the human needs of people in the neighborhood and some people out of the neighborhood. People come in and, you know, they go through so much and you just don't know what people are going through. It started off with just giving sandwiches out because someone came by and they were inquiring about something to eat. We had nothing on the premises. So we sat down and we discussed about doing something about if someone ever come to the neighborhood, what can we give them? We have an after school program. We had a back to school outreach at Mazik. It was wonderful. We gave out books, pencils, crayons. It was a numerous things they gave out. We have family night. The families come and they interact with the children. We also have a summer camp. We do summer camp every summer. We go to the skating rink. We go to the bowling alley. They take the children to the park. We do a dance to care, and this is every Friday. We have two locations. We also do an angel tree, and that's to help some children that's unfortunate to get Christmas gifts. The people that do come in, they come back and they let us know how much we have transformed their life.
God has blessed us to impact the community in many ways, such as our prison ministry, the Hagar's House, which has helped a number of people already transition from difficult challenges into being overcomers. With so many opportunities, we have impacted socially, politically, but most of all, by God's Spirit.